Hello, in this video I will explain what is Cuckoo Search Algorithm and how it works. Topics covered in this video: what is Cuckoo Search, how this algorithm works, and how we can initialize the population for Cuckoo Search, how we can implement this algorithm. Then we have a numerical example for easy explanation of this algorithm. And here in this video, this algorithm is explained step by step for easy understanding. Then we have what is objective function, what is fitness value, what is optimization, how we can calculate the step size for each cuckoo, how we can calculate the fitness value for each cuckoo. So, you know, what is Cuckoo Search Algorithm? It is a metaheuristic algorithm that is inspired by some species of cuckoos, you know, their behavior of laying their egg in the nest of other species. And, you know, as this behavior, they are laying their egg in the nest of other species, it increases their survival and their population. And in this algorithm we have two species, that is cuckoo bird and the host bird. Here we are denoting other species bird by host bird. And you know the behavior of the cuckoo bird, they do not have their own nest, so they are laying the egg in the nest of host bird. And as they are laying their egg in the nest of other species, so there is a probability of discovery of the cuckoo's egg. So once the cuckoo's egg is discovered by host bird, it can either throw away or it can build a new nest. There is only 10% probability of discovery of the cuckoo's egg by the host bird. And we will represent this situation using this probability, that is the probability of discovery of the cuckoo's egg. Here, for simplicity, we will use three rules, that is, each cuckoo lay only one egg at a time and it can place it in a randomly selected nest. And the best nest with high quality of egg will carry over to the next generation. Third one is, number of host nest is fixed and you know the probability of discovery of the host cuckoo's egg by the host bird. Then this is the algorithm that is given in the research paper, that is Cuckoo Search by Levy's flight. We are going to implement this algorithm through example. Point, you know what is optimization, that is optimum, that is the point where conditions are best or most favorable. So why we are doing optimization? We are trying to find the better or the best solution among all. So what is objective function? They are used to maximize or minimize the values that we are trying to optimize. So first step of this algorithm is initialize the population of n host nest. Rule is here, the size of the population should be 50 to 20 times the number of the design variable. So in this video, for example, I will take population size for 5. So we have only 5 host nest, and you know the parameters, that is, for the population we need total number of host nest, that is the population size. You can see this code here. This is for the generation of initial population for the host nest. I provided a link in the description box. You can see, you can also check the, for this code, you can search in Google about Cuckoo Search code in MATLAB. You can get this link in the MATLAB file exchange. So in this code, you know, they used population, I used population size 5, that is the number of host nest, then the parameters, maximum iterations, then they use the domain in between minus 5 to 5, and then we have this is the Cuckoo Search population initialization. And you know, this is the output of this code. Here we initialize the population for 5 cuckoos. Here I'm saying cuckoo, you know, we cannot make any difference between nest, cuckoo, egg. So you can see either nest, cuckoo or anything else, I'm using here cuckoos. After the initialization of population, we will calculate the fitness value, that is the using objective function fxi, calculate the fitness value for each cuckoo. And you can see here, for the this is x1 and these values for x2, and put the value in the objective function. And you know, for the first cuckoo, value of x1 is this, value of x2 is this, put the value and you will get the fitness value for first cuckoo, this. Like that, we will calculate the fitness value for each cuckoo. After that, you can see finally we calculated the values for each cuckoo. Next step is here, you know, the probability of discovery of the cuckoo egg by the host egg. We will take the value 0.25. And you know, the aim of this algorithm is we will use better solution and we will replace the bad solution with the best one that are in the current population. After that, next step is we will obtain a new position for the ith cuckoo randomly while Levy's flight. So right now you can select any cuckoo randomly. I'm selecting here first cuckoo, then I will apply Levy's flight on the first cuckoo, then I will calculate its new position. So Levy's flight is performed by this. So before calculating the new position, we will calculate Levy's flight. This is the new solution that we are generating for the first cuckoo. This is the current location of the cuckoo. Step size, you know, the step size value for the step size in some research paper, they use 0.01, and other, that is the main search paper, that is Cuckoo Search by Levy's flight, they use 1. I'm using here 1. This is entry wise multiplication, this is Levy's exponent. And now, you know, Cuckoo Search algorithm is a random search that is done by a word that is cuckoo. Cuckoo is searching for the suitable nest for laying egg. So now Levy's flight is used here for random walk that is done by the word cuckoo. You know, here the step size that is denoted by this S. This is the step size that determine how far a random walker can go for a fixed number of iterations. If the step size is value that you calculated for S is small, then change in position will be too small. If it is larger, then it will be far away from the older one. So it is important to take the proper value for the step size. You know, in order to calculate the step size, we need to calculate values for sigma, u, u and v. So this is the standard deviation, and we will use the value of beta here, 3/2, that is 1.5. Okay, put the value here and you will got this value, that is 0.6966. After that, we will calculate values for u and v. You can see the code here, that is random number, that is uniformly distributed random number multiplied by sigma u. And here we will calculate the value for the each cuckoo for x1 and for x2. This is calculation for x1, for ux1, for ux2. And this is the, put the value, choose any random number that is uniformly distributed, put the value of sigma u, and you can see the calculation result here for x1, and this is for x2, you can see here, done. Next, for v, again choose any random number that is uniformly distributed, after that put the value of sigma v, and you can see the values calculated this. Now we finally calculated values for u and v. Now we can calculate the step size for the cuckoo run. Now put the value of the sigma u, u and v here. Now you can see there is a, we will calculate value for x1, for x2, for each cuckoo we will do this. And you know, the value of u, x1 is here, and value of v, x1 is here, and sigma u is this one. For example, you can see here, this is the sigma u for both is same, x1 x2. This is the value of u that we calculated here, and this is the value of v that we calculated here. Done, put the values and then we will calculate this. After that we will update the values here, like that we will do for all. Done. Next, you can see here, this is the fitness value and we have some cuckoos. We will choose the current best. Now according to their fitness value, we will choose the current best. You know, the if the fitness value of the word that is cuckoo is minimum, it means it is the best solution. If the fitness value is greater, larger one, that means the worst value. So we will consider the minimum value as we are doing optimization. This is optimization algorithm, so we need minimum value. So out of 5 cuckoo, we have cuckoo number 5, that is the minimum fitness value. So this is the current best position, and we will use this solution in order to update the values. So you know, we have the G best, that is global best, is 5th cuckoo, And now we will update the position of Cuckoo. We have the global west, we have the step size, and we will consider this 1, or you can take 0.01. This for x1 and x2. Here you can see, for we will set the counter 0. That's it. So for the first Cuckoo, x1 is this one, x2 is this one. Step size for x1, this value. Step size for x2, this value. Put the value here. For x1, value is used this. Step size for this is this one. And put the value, you will got this. After that, we will calculate its fitness using objective function. And we got the new fitness value for the first Cuckoo is 16.3307. After that, we will select nest randomly and we will compare the fitness value of the Cuckoo and with the randomly selected nest. You can see here the fitness value that we generated recently is better as compared to the randomly selected nest. You know, the fitness value, as I told you before, how fit solution is. If value is high, it means worse. If value is low, it means better. In this case, Cuckoo fitness value is better. Now the replace randomly selected nest with this value. So we replaced all the values of x1, x2 and the fitness value. Next, we will compute for second Cuckoo. Again, put the values here and calculate its fitness. Then compare the fitness value that you recently calculated with the older one. Then update all the values. For the each Cuckoo, you can see I calculated the values here. And in this case, you can see we calculated value for third Cuckoo is 36.9333. That is the worst case, so there is no need for the replacement. Like that, we will update the values for all. After that, you can see these are the older value and they have the recently updated value. Now we will use these values. Now, you know, the egg is now replaced. Now you can see there is a probability of discovery of the Cuckoo's egg by the host egg, and we will use the values 0.25 for this. So in a research paper that is Cuckoo Search Algorithm for Multimodal Optimization, they use this operation in order to replace the worst nest with the newer one. So I am using this here. Here R1 is the uniform random number and you can generate these range 0 to 1. And if the value of R1 is less than probability value, that is 0.25, then the individual is selected and we will modify it. It means the Cuckoo's egg is discovered. If the value is greater, it means the egg is not discovered, so there is no need to do anything, remain as it is. So use this value, and d1, d2 are the random integer and value is 1 to n. Here n is 5, so we will use the value for d1, d2, 1 to 5. In this way, new solution can be replaced by the host nest. Value of the probability is greater, then we will select the nest for modification. Here there is no need for the modification. So we will take it as it is. Next, for the Cuckoo 2, you can see we selected a random number and this value is smaller than the probability. So we will now select the nest and we will modify it. For the modification, we will use this operation. And here we will put the initial position. After that, we will use any random number. Then we will calculate value for x1 and x2. And this is the value calculated for x1. Here d1 is used, 4, d2 is used, 2. Put the value here. This is updated for x1. Now for this is updated for x2. Then calculate the fitness value. Now for the third Cuckoo, you can see select any random number, compare the value and update it. Like that, we will do for all the Cuckoos. Now we will compare the fitness value again. If the fitness value of newly generated nest is better, then it is accepted, else we will replace it. So here you can see for the, these are the previous calculated value and the new calculated value. So compare the fitness value. You can see the fitness value of the first Cuckoo is equal, so there is no need to change it. Fitness value of the second Cuckoo here, this one is better, so we will replace the second Cuckoo's fitness value using this. You can see we replace this. Third is value is equal, no need to change, value is equal, no need to change, value is equal, no need to change. So we replace the second cuckoo's fitness value and its position. Now we will select the best quality solutions, that is we will rank the solution and we will find the current best. So according to this you can see, according to their rank, we have the best cuckoo, that is cuckoo number 5, then we have 4, cuckoo number 4, value is this 3, 1. So we have now worst best position, that is the current best is cuckoo number 5. This is the output of the cuckoo search by Levy slide. I provided that link for the source code, that is in the MATLAB file exchange. This is the output of their research work. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.